Litzau, and I'm an account director here at 90octane. And I've been with the company actually only since May, so I'm really happy to be here and to be in front of you tonight. One of the privileges of working at 90octane has been to become a member of the BMA Colorado chapter. And in the past 2 months, I have had the privilege to go to a couple of really outstanding events. The first one was B2B Rising, the Revolution in Marketing Leadership. And that was a half-day regional conference among business leaders who were talking about navigating the new marketing landscape. And the sessions were designed to help B2B marketers really learn effective strategies and tactics and get creative ideas for growing their organizations. The agenda had an opening keynote, some panel discussions, some TEDx-style presentations, and then a closing keynote. From this event, I'll be focusing on two sessions. The first one was the opening keynote by Mark Sanborn, who is the president of Sanborn Associates. And he's the author of several books, an accomplished writer and speaker on leadership. And as well, I'll be speaking about the second was a TED presenter. His name was Aaron Kennedy. And he's the current CMO of the state of Colorado. And he talked about the process that they went through for creating the new branding for the state of Colorado. The second event I got to go to was a BMA keynote meeting called Epic Content, and that featured Joe Polizzi, which was the speaker that Rosemary talked about a little bit earlier. He's really a self-proclaimed evangelist on content marketing, and he has founded the Content Marketing Institute, has written several books, and speaks very extensively on content marketing. And he really talks about the what, how, and why of content marketing. The common theme from each of these speakers was leadership. And leadership really has many forms. And it really depends on who you're talking to and the context in which you're talking about what type of leadership you're actually thinking about. There's individual leadership, there's business leadership, there's strategic leadership, marketing, team, compassionate, blah, 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 right? There's all these types of leadership. In business, leadership is really an intersection of the personal and the business, the professional side. As individuals, we seek leadership to really guide us through difficult times, create a clear path, and capitalize on challenges that are really exciting to us. As businesses, we seek leadership in our industry or market or category through innovation and differentiation and in ways to engage our customers in a way that nobody or no other business can. Getting to the next level in our business really takes work in all these areas of leadership to some degree, and that's really what these speakers focused on. The BMA quoted these two facts in their research in the B2B Rising event. That's 97% of B2B marketers are doing things they have never done before as part of marketing, and 34% said they feel overwhelmed by change. Because the marketing landscape is changing so rapidly and drastically, really, for a lot of B2B marketers, more and more of us will be seeking leadership in as individual leadership as well as business leadership. And the BMA speakers really drove home three key areas of leadership that affect us as we adapt to change and as we actually excel through it. The first is personal leadership in the business setting. The second is strategic leadership through data, methodology, and collaboration. And the third is category leadership through content marketing. So first, let's talk about what Mark Sanborn had to say in his keynote, which I really saw as personal leadership in the business setting. So great leaders know what really matters and are able to make it matter to everyone else. Mark started out his presentation with some questions that he asked of the audience, and they were sort of trick questions because if you weren't really listening, you would start to make some assumptions and maybe come up with a wrong answer instead of the right answer. For example, one of the questions was, how many birthdays does the average male have? So think about that for a second. If you were like me, you wrote down 72 because the average male has 72 birthdays in their lifetime. But if you were like my friend Casey, raise your hand. He was at the event with me. He wrote down the right answer, which was one. Because the average male is only born once. We only have one birthday. So what we need to remember is we need to think about what really matters. Mark talked about the critical questions that we as marketers should be asking today. How do we become distinctive? Are we pursuing our potential? Are our people, our employees, engaged? And how do we get customers involved? He said that really we don't need more data, we need more insight. We don't need more emulation, we need more innovation. Not more activity, more accomplishment. And not more communication, but more community. He went on to say that to be a good leader in business, really during these challenging and really changing times, we need to focus on six key areas of leadership. And you'll notice that they really are how we should be leading as individuals. The first one is self-mastery. Why would anyone follow you? Because you're competent. Because you have character. And because you make connections with other people. The second is shared focus. And he said that focus really beats brains or brawn anytime. That you should identify the top things that are most important, that you should spend most of your day working on those, and you should make absolutely sure that everyone on your team is focused on the same things that you are. The third one is power to the people, and it's really with the people, not over the people. Persuasive communication. And what he was really talking about here is that we should be using selling as a way to help our customers make really good decisions about things that will benefit and value their business. Strategic execution. It's a common knowledge about the strategy and a consistent application of it. And then the last is service. That we should not take from others, but it's really what we give that matters. The next top takeaway is from Aaron Kennedy's presentation, Colorado Blueprint, where he discussed the process that he led in developing the new branding for Colorado. And I really saw his message as the strategic leadership through data, methodology, and collaboration. I'm sure many of you are aware of the controversy that surrounds the resulting logo and branding that came out of the process that Aaron led, part of which you see represented up here. In short, the project cost over $1 million of taxpayer money, and many people felt that the result was not really worthy of the spend. However, the resulting branding is simple, straightforward, clear, and to the point, which was exactly what the research said that it should look like. But all opinions and controversy aside, the leadership demonstrated here really was to follow the data. And that's not unlike how we approach things here at 90 Octane. Aaron and his team of Colorado designers and writers established an objective and followed through a methodology for systematically gathering data to tell them really how they should create this brand. They did thousands of interviews with people both in the state and outside of the state to drive really how this brand should look. For example, the data told them that the red C in the Colorado state flag that we're all really proud of, it actually is associated with Chicago. So we really don't want to design something around that. The data also said that there was an overwhelming association of Colorado with mountains, right? And it's not just the physical activity with the mountains, but also the very personal inspiration that we all gain from the mountains here in our state. So they really built on that strength when they created the brand for the state. Finally, the implementation of the brand is a brand by Colorado for Colorado, which demonstrates the leadership of the collaboration of the multiple people who really worked on it. And then the last takeaway is the presentation by Joe Polizzi. And I really love Joe's presentation because he spoke so strongly to where we are going with our clients related to content. And it's really a driving factor in creating engagement among our customers and clients and developing the strategy for bringing our clients to be category leaders. Joe provided a lot of valuable information. I know Rosemary talked a lot about that, about what content marketing is. I did put up the definition there just in case you want to see that. But what the main message I really took from his presentation is that we can become content leaders in our industries or markets or categories, however you want to think about it, by focusing our efforts in content around marketing to-dos, these 10 to-dos that he has up here, and asking about the why for every channel. He first directed us actually to watch a couple of videos that Coca-Cola has posted up on their YouTube page. And these videos talk a lot about how they develop content, but what's so fascinating about the videos isn't just the approach that they're using, but that they are really examples of how they are being leaders in developing content in their industry. Joe noted in his presentation a few other companies that are also leaders around content, including American Express, Procter & Gamble, and a B2B company called Indium. And I would encourage you to go look those up. They're really great examples. I'm also really excited to start working on number two, which is content marketing mission statements with our clients as we go into 2014. Because like other mission statements that we're all familiar with, they really do drive what we want to be doing with everything related to content. They're really driving the why. The rest of the steps seem pretty straightforward, but it's really number three, be the leading information expert in your industry, that really kind of takes it away for me. Joe said that content will create better customers, and you can't be a leader without creating your own content. So I'd like to leave you with a few quotes from some other leaders that you're familiar with that truly illustrate the intersection of the personal with the professional leadership that I've been talking about as the theme. Leadership comes in small acts as well as bold strokes. This reminds us that leadership at all levels of our work and interactions with others are extremely important. It is, after all, the responsibility of the expert to operate the familiar and that of the leader to transcend it. Remember that getting to the next level really does take both individual as well as business leadership. Innovation distinguishes between a leader and a follower. Men make history, not the other way around. In periods where there is no leadership, society stands still. Progress occurs when courageous, skillful leaders seize the opportunity to change things for the better. Leadership accepts the challenge of change and excels through it. And whatever you are, be a good one. Whatever kind of leadership you're striving for, whether it's mastery at the individual level or strategic level or the category level, do it well. Thank you.